I'm Professor Alexey Karpenko, the founder and partner of EmCell Company. I would like to tell you about the promise, clinical promise for pluripotent stem cells. Pluripotent stem cell therapy. Remember it because it will help you to live a long, healthy life. Let me turn you back for about 20 years. It was the moment when the second source for pluripotent stem cells was suggested. Let me show you the quotation of a very interesting document. It is a statement in front of Senate of the United States of the top person in medicine of the United States of that moment, director of National Institutes of Health, Nobel laureate, Professor Harald Varmus.
There is almost no realm of medicine that might not be touched by this innovation. Perhaps the most far-reaching potential application of human pluripotent stem cells is the generation of cells and tissue that could be used for transplantation, so-called cell therapies. It's not too unrealistic to say that this research has the potential to revolutionize the practice of medicine and improve the quality and length of life.
We may suggest calling such promised cell therapy a dream stem cell therapy. So the question was, which kind of pluripotent stem cells can fulfill the promise?
In Dr. Thompson's work, cells were derived from embryos created by in vitro fertilization, but not used for infertility treatment. This work falls clearly within the congressional ban on human embryonic research. The National Institutes of Health could not and did not support Dr. Thompson's recent work.
So, Professor Varmus did not mean that embryonic stem cells would be used in clinical practice.
Dr. Gearhart derived his pluripotent stem cells from fetal tissue from terminated pregnancies. The Public Health Service Act authorizes federal funding of human fetal tissue research and provides safeguards for its conduct. The department may conduct or support research on the transplantation of human fetal tissue for therapeutic reasons. The National Institutes of Health could have supported his recent work deriving pluripotent stem cells from fetal tissue.
Thus, the promise of pluripotent stem cells related only for fetal pluripotent stem cells. We at EmCell use pluripotent fetal stem cells in our daily clinical practice for already 26 years. Let me tell you about features of fetal stem cells that we have revealed during these times. It appeared that pluripotent stem cells have a unique set of clinically favorable features.
Professor Varmus and others have pointed out the potential problem of histoincompatibility, or the body's rejection of the fetal stem cells. Before we can use these cells for transplantation, we must overcome the well-known problem of immune rejection. However, it turns out that transplanted pluripotent fetal stem cells are not rejected by the recipient. Even though they are genetically unmatched, pluripotent fetal stem cell transplants do not result in tissue rejection. They do not need to be matched to the donor and do not require any suppression of the recipient's immune system, as such immune suppression can cause adverse complications and unneeded negative side effects. As a result, pluripotent fetal stem cell transplantations can be used safely for the treatment of a great variety of diseases, including the prevention and treatment of age-related diseases and conditions while posing zero risk to the patient. In fact, it was also discovered that pluripotent fetal stem cells actually interrupt autoimmune aggression. Fetal stem cells are the only known curative agent to treat autoimmune diseases such as diabetes type 1, rheumatoid arthritis, multiple sclerosis, ulcerative colitis, and many more. These pluripotent fetal stem cells have the strongest curative potency over any other stem cell type. Fetal stem cells are the most potent of all stem cells, followed by umbilical cord blood stem cells, and then bone marrow hematopoietic stem cells, and finally the lowest potency stem cell type, mesenchymal stem cells. transplanted pluripotent fetal stem cells perform no curative effects by themselves. The curative effects of fetal stem cells belong to their specialized posterity in several generations that relate to the particular ailing tissues of a particular recipient. Transplanted pluripotent fetal stem cells can give rise to any kind of specialized cells that are lacking or weakened in the recipient's body. As a result, it has been observed that only a few kinds of these fetal pluripotent stem cells have a strong universal potency that can actually cure a great variety of diseases.
The next very important feature of pluripotent fetal stem cells, they do not any curative effect in a young, healthy person. Strong, healthy tissues of young persons do not allow space for pluripotent stem cells surviving and living. Only weak, damaged, or aging tissues are sufficient space for living of pluripotent stem cells. So, pluripotent stem cells are seeking for such tissues as a space for living. This means they are revealing such places. They are diagnostic the tissue of the patient, self-guided diagnostic of the tissues. In the most fine possibility that they have got is something new for a treatment agent. As a result, transplanted pluripotent stem cells provide most specific, fine diagnostic of ailing tissues. Then they settled in the places of such damaged tissue. They live there. They produce the posterity which is appropriate for this specific ailing tissue. And this means that they are recovering this tissue and recovering the function of this tissue by themselves. And the main transplanted pluripotent stem cells can provide such curative activity to any kind of the tissues in the body. They do in a holistic way. Thus, a transplanted pluripotent stem cells are the new kind of curative agent. Despite being non-matched tissue, they are not rejected in recipient. They provide self-guided diagnostic of the tissue, of the ailing tissue. They provide specialized cell posterity for treatment of the ailing tissue. They act in this manner systemically toward to all tissues of the body. They work according to the needs of the patient, and they work under the regulation of the body of the patient. Such curative agent is unique and new in the history of medicine. With the use of transplanted pluripotent stem cells, we created EmCell therapy, which means we take the best contemporary method of treatment particular disease and enrich it in particular crucial moment of the evolving of the disease with the fetal stem cell transplantation. And it makes possibility of modern therapy much wider. So we believe that it is dream stem cell therapy, or at least it is a basis for a future dream stem cell therapy.